what it states is that since they took money out of circulation, real money, which is gold and silver, then they would pay for everything dollar for dollar on the public sector. That means they would cover all of our debts dollar for dollar in the public sector. So the birth certificate, unless we take control of it, the state appoints an executor to control it. And so when we're out and we're actually working to earn a living, we're really just like paying ourselves, because that comes from our signature, since there's no real money, in our energy. So the workers are the real source of money right now, because the only thing that really exists is money of an account. And so that sounds crazy until, like, if you've actually ever had your credit compromised, right? That happened to me once. I swiped my card in Florida and someone in California was withdrawing funds from the account. So I contact PayPal and say, hey, there's $5,000 missing from my account. And they say, well, it's obviously not you because you just checked in Florida. So I think they probably used a scanner or something. And within a few hours, the money, well, what they referred to as money, was actually restored into the account. Why? Because there was nothing tangible, right? So no one really lost anything. It was just money of an account. So they just went to a computer and punched in some numbers. But it was nothing tangible like gold or silver. So there is no money. I mean, I can't understand it, believe it or not, but there's really no money. So, and all of this is actually tied into the birth certificate, which is a contract, and the Social Security, which is a contract. So the Social Security, the front is always public. The back is always private. So the number on the front essentially belongs to the straw man. The back, when you look at the back of it, there's a letter followed by some numbers. That letter points you to the Federal Reserve Bank that's actually holding your treasury account. And the number behind it, if you add two zeros, points you to the account number. So you have a Rollin number. Same thing you need to start direct deposit, right? If I went into Chase Bank and I wanted to start direct deposit with my job, they're going to ask me for two things. They're going to ask me for the routing number to the bank that identifies the bank, and they will ask me for the account number. They could direct deposit the fiat right into my account. But so the birth certificate is the contract from which all other so-called identifications come from. If I need a driver's license, if I need a CDL, if I need anything, that birth certificate is the primary document that she signed off for, which is a contract. So it all goes back to contracts again. That was kind of long, but yeah.
Yeah, and I appreciate that. The thing about, and if we're tying this back to relationships, is once you become aware that, hey, this birth certificate was a contract and you were a baby when this contract went down, and then you're 18 and you kind of like consent to it because you don't even know that it's a contract, then say you get into a relationship and a marriage, again, you're signing away your authority, and you don't even know it. I guess my question is for the viewers, like, do you realize how that affects your energy and how you show up in life? And maybe you can speak to that and in unwinding and becoming aware consciously of how the system works.
Right. So because I was not the legal age of majority when mom and dad signed the contract for me to get a Social Security and for me to get the birth certificate. Once I become the legal age of majority, in some states, it's different. Some states, it used to be 16. Some states, it's 17. But for most states now, it's 18. So once I become the legal age of majority, I'm no longer obliged to that contract and the birth certificate. But what are we taught to do? We're taught to go out and get a job, or a job, or just over broke. Remember, Job lost everything. So he went out and got a just over broke, a job. And so when we get a job, what must we do? We have to fill out an application for a contract. But they also teach us that we have to complete a W-2, W-4, right? And so at the end of the year, what do? We got to file a 1040. And so the 1040, even if I'm now the legal age of majority, what I just did was put myself right back into the system. Because once I become 18, if I don't work, if I don't sign the 1040 or any of that, then I'm not recontracting with the state. But I myself just voluntarily recontracted with the state. So now all of these things, I just confirmed that, hey, I still want to be a debtor. So essentially, most people think that if you have a notice on most applications that you fill out, it'll ask you, are you a U.S. citizen? Why are they asking that? Because they already know, right? They already know that we're U.S. citizen because I have an ID saying that, right? I have a birth certificate saying that. So you got to think, why would they ask that? They're asking that because they're giving you the opportunity to opt out. What if I put, no, I'm not a U.S. citizen. I'm an American, right? Which would actually make me an American national. So essentially, we have two citizenships. We have a dual citizenship, but no one ever teaches us this, right? So the first citizenship is you're born an American, I'm an American. But with the birth certificate, a new citizenship is created known as a U.S. citizen. And a U.S. citizen is not what we was taught in geography class, right? We're thinking that, oh yeah, well, I'm a citizen of the 50 states united. That's not what that means. When they refer to a U.S. citizenship, they're referring to 28 U.S.C. 3002, subsection 15A, which is a federal corporation. So now, essentially what I'm saying is I'm a citizen of the District of Columbia, which is a 10 square mile radius, not of the 50 states united. It's not that U.S. that is talking about. And if you read the Constitution, which most people don't, it's always making a distinction between the United States and the several states. Why is it making that distinction? Because the United States is the District of Columbia, Washington, D.C., which is a corporation. It is not referring to the 50 states united.